right, welcome back. Wolf just got denied the welcome back.
I did.
He said welcome back. Our mics weren't turned on yet. Anyway, so welcome back to the GSTL Global StarCraft II Team League here in Seoul, Korea, Mokdong at the Mokdong Studio. We are here with Zenix versus Hossa. If you are just joining us, Seal is on a rampage. He is your player on the right, representing Ennis Hossa, and he's going to be facing Zenix Line now. What was it, Suho Shin?
Yeah.
Suho Shin is his new ID.
Yeah.
On Tal'Darim Altar.
Here we
go. We're going to jump straight into the game and see if Line can bring it home and keep his team alive, or will Seal the deal. And here is our Zerg player representing Zenix.
Zenix Suho Shin.
I may just have to call him Line.
Yeah, we're very used to calling this guy Line.
I have a feeling I'll stumble over it. But here is his competitor who has already won 3 games.
And it's Hossa, Seal.
Could he win a 4th, man? He just might.
He could get an all kill. The foreign fan who's here to support Seal may get his wish.
Reseal the Guardian, then there's like a Seal there also.
Right. There you go.
So I'm telling you, man, multiple meanings. Well,
wow.
ZvZ is definitely Suho Shin's best matchup.
And we do have a 10 pool coming out for Zenix Suho Shin. And I'm curious what Seal's going to do, because he does appear to be going towards... he's building up drones. I'm curious if he's going to hatch first or if he's going to... No, he's going to pool and then hatch on 14. Pool... I completely messed up. He's going to extractor and then pool in 14. Sorry.
Yep. There it is.
There it is. So he's actually going to be completely safe against this 10 pool. And it's going to be actually in an advantage.
Yeah, he should be. And this basically is going to punish him when he goes for hatch first. But in this case, there's no one going for hatch first. There's no one to punish.
Yeah, and the 14 gas... And then pool is a very safe build.
Yeah, it's very safe.
Against this 10 pool, or even sometimes against 6 pool. So, very smart move.
Especially on a map like this, it's very large. Luckily, though, he is going to scout very quickly where his opponent is. Oh, he's not going to see that Overlord. Not going to see it as quickly as he could have.
Yeah, so I'm not surprised Seal's being really safe about this. Oh, this is interesting. Yeah, he saw the creep, so he knew where he was, but he... didn't want to show his drone, it seemed like, but now he's shown it. Zerglings are on the way.
He should be perfectly fine. The queen isn't going to be out for a while, but with his drones and his own Zerglings that are going to be in very close number, he should be fine. In fact, he's not even going to send his lings to that base.
Whoa, what? Where's...
Oh, he's going to...
Oh, he's going to hide
he's
them.
He's going to hide them for a little bit.
And, oh, this is actually pretty smart. He's going to hide those Zerglings so he doesn't know they're there until he has a lot more, and then just rush in with a lot at once. And now he shows those Zerglings, though. He's going to pick off one. Is he going to counterattack? Baneling Nest is going up in the main for Seal.
Yeah, that's going to actually be really helpful. But...
I don't know if it's going to be in time, though.
Yeah, he's not going to have any... He doesn't really have any Lings at home right now.
It's going to take a lot of micro
queen
to deal
positioning.
With this.
Spine trying to go up here, but he's not going to quite get that. Does end up losing it.
Yeah, he's going to depend on the queen, and more Zerglings coming out for Seal. So he's actually got about an even number of Zerglings here. A little bit of a fight going on. Neither player microing too much, but Seal, just with a couple extra Zerglings, wins the day there. And, wow. Suho Shin is actually now kind of in trouble.
Yeah, he's in a lot of trouble. Seal's got better lings. He's about to have some Banelings at his front door as well. He's making his own Baneling nest, but I don't think that's going to be up in time. And guess what, man? Seal has Zergling speed. That means his lings can do whatever he wants. He doesn't know where his opponent is yet, so he's going the wrong direction, unfortunately, for him.
Oh, that's funny.
But he's going to find out pretty soon. That's what's going on. He sees the Overlord. And I just don't think there's any way... that Suho Shin is going to be able to hold this. He's made a spine. His early speed isn't going to be done in time, though. He's not going to have enough units, and look at this.
And he got the Baneling Nest as well, so Seal is—he's morphed some of the Zerglings that were near the base into Banelings, so he's gonna have a couple of those. Baneling Nest is up now for Line as well,
making
morphing
some of his
Banelings,
own.
But this is gonna come down to some crazy micro. It's gonna be both players trying to kill Banelings with single Zerglings, both players trying to land Banelings on multiple Zerglings.
Uh-oh, and two Banelings versus two. That was two
that was
for two
silly.
There. That was kind of silly. We may have it again.
And is he going to get? Where is he? Oh, he's going for the drones. He gets.
Several drones do go down. But look at this. He's got so many more Banelings back at the front of the natural.
He needs to protect them with his Zerglings, though, because otherwise these Banelings are just going to trade like that. He's going for more drones. Gets a couple more drones. And gets almost all of Suoshin's Zerglings. And now he's just going for the kill. He's got so many Zerglings, it doesn't even matter.
This is looking really bad. The Spine's going to go down here. More drones taking damage. Queen goes down. Spine goes down. It looks like Seal going to get all 4 points here.
Wow, and this is going to be huge. Hoso needed as many points as possible to clinch first place.
Gigi.
And there's the GG. Hoso has clinched first place in their division with a 4-1 win and an all kill by Seal. Very nicely done. And Zenex is going to be 1-4 in their division. I believe they may have clinched last.
Yeah, most likely going to be the case. Not a very good points distribution either. And, you know, they decide to use Line instead of Puzzle. Came back to bite them a little bit.
Actually, I think there might be a situation where if the second place team gets an all kill, they might tie for first. Actually, because they were up by one, and so they only got a +3 on this instead of a +4. So if the other team gets +4, then they'll be tied for first. That'll be interesting. I wonder how they'll determine that.
That's a big question.
Maybe they'll determine it based on who beat who in the league play or something like that.
Yeah, they might do a little playoff game or something like that. That'll be interesting. Maybe.
Maybe. We will see, but of course, that means that the second place team, I forget who it is, it's StarTail?
It's not IAM, it's StarTail, yeah.
StarTail, yeah. If StarTail gets an all kill, then that will be an issue, but if not, then Hoso will be first place. They will have clinched it, and that's pretty impressive, man, considering, you know, they're not that well-known of a team. They don't have any of, like, the big star players. You know, they don't have your MVPs and your Nesties and your, you know, any of the players that are, like, have won championships. And they're doing better than any of the teams that do have championship winner players on their team. So very, very impressive play this season by Enes Hoso.
Yeah, they've been doing a great job, honestly. They're just that little academy team, man.
And there's the results for today. Byun did manage to beat Tassadar first off, but then Seal was able to seal victory with 4 wins of his own.
You know, I'm looking over at the Zenex team, and I don't think Puzzle's there. I just don't think he's here today.
Oh, really?
I don't know if there's a reason for that, but he doesn't appear to be here today.
That would
explain
why they didn't send him out.
Yeah, exactly. So, well, that really affected how things turned out. And, little explanation needed there.
Seal crushed through everyone. That wasn't a huge deal for Zenex anyways, because, you know, they were basically, there was no way they could get into the playoffs. They were at 1-3, and there were three teams with 3 wins, so they couldn't tie any of them. So no way for them to get into the playoffs. So no real pressure on them. They didn't seem like they're at crest or anything like that.
The only thing that hurts is their pride. And a little bit, of course, I'm sure their seeding into the next season of GSTL will be affected by this, of course, as well. So that's kind of rough, but we're going to take a look at
interview with the MVP. I wonder who it's going to be. 승리했는데요.
오늘의 승리팀 NS 호사팀 만나보도록 하겠습니다. 자, 우선 오늘의 MVP 선수입니다. 바로 이준 선수인데요. 네, 오늘 올킬 기록하셨어요. 축하드려요.
And he's there with his coach.
제가 지난번 인터뷰 때는 또 우리 이준 선수가 웃기만 하다 하셨는데 오늘은 마지막이니까 마음껏 하고 싶은 말 하셔도 됩니다. 자, MVP 소감이 어떠신가요?
제가 팀의 힘이 돼서 정말 기쁘고
Right, and he says he's happy that he could win for his team.
정말 좋습니다.
네, 알겠어요. 역시나 또 미소답게 웃기만 하시는데요. 팀 내 별명이 미소자고요. 알고 계시나요?
네.
마음에 드시나요, 별명?
She's saying that last time.
워낙 이준 선수가 말수가 적고 웃기만 한다. 뭐 이런 말씀 해주셨는데.
He was on an interview. He was only smiling at the camera. He's being very shy.
저는 이런 사람이다.
I'm actually not sure if that's the translation, but what's going on?
네, 역시 표정 별명이 딱 들어맞는 것 같아요. 자, 오늘 그러면 부모님에게 지금 또 이 인터뷰 영상을
주고
계신데 부모님에게 또 영상 편지 한 장 네, 알려주시죠.
Any comments to your parents that will be watching?
열심히 노력해서 멋진 선수가 될게요. 사랑해요.
아, 네, 정말 훈훈한 마무리였습니다. 네, 고맙습니다.
He says, I will try the best I can to become
the best
player I can. 그리고
박영식 감독님, 오늘 1위로 플레이오프에 직행하게 됐어요. 어떠신가요?
아, 예, 당연히 기분이 좋고요.
네.
한숨을 좀 놓인 것 같고 이제 플레이오프 진출을 하는 거 이제 보고
relieved that they've secured their first place spot.
열심히 연습을 하도록 하겠습니다.
네, 패넌트 레이스는 오늘부터 끝났는데요. 네, 오늘 마지막 경기도 또 이렇게 멋지게 치러낸 우리 팀원들에게 한 말씀 해주시죠.
네, 정말 선수들한테 너무너무 감사하고 그 힘든 내부 일정에도 코치 아무 말 없이 따라준 거에 대해서 너무너무 감사하고 이번에 이제 자신감으로 개인전도 많이 진출했으면 하는 바람이고요. 저번 지금까지 이제 그 프로토스 선수가 먼저 올킬을 하고 그다음 테란이 올킬을 하고 그다음 이준 선수 저그가 올킬을 하고 그래서 저희 팀에 각 종종 한 명씩이 올킬을 해냈다는 점에서도 오늘 정말 뜻깊은 날이 아닌가 싶어요.
He said on his team there's been a Terran, a Zerg, and a Protoss each on his team that has done an all kill. So he's very proud of his team.
올킬 나올 수 있기도 기대하겠습니다. 네. 감사합니다. 네. 네, 저는 지금까지 오늘 승리팀이었습니다. NS호서 팀을 만나봤고요. 저는 다음 주 경기가 끝나고 다시 찾아보도록 하겠습니다.
Alright, so there you have it. NS호서, I didn't even realize they got three all kills this season actually.
Yeah. Seal got one, Sage got one, and Jakji got one.
Really?
Yep. So
I did not know that Sage got an all kill. I actually was so busy because the GSTL started when I was like packing and trying to get
traveling.
My life in order and stuff. Mm. So I didn't watch like the first few weeks of the team leagues.
Yep.
But anyway, that's gonna be it for today. We hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to tune in for Project A this evening. Here's one last look at the standings. And there you see NS:HOSO in first with +8. StarTail is at +4. But again, if they get that all kill, somehow they could tie at +8. And IM has pretty much clinched the, well, not necessarily actually clinched the third place spot. It depends on what FOU does in their last match. And we're going to see how that happens next week. Next week, I believe, will be the last week of divisional play. And it will be FUnited versus OGSTL. And MVP versus TSL on Thursday.
MVP versus TSL, that is the match to watch.
Yeah, that is actually going to be pretty important.
It's going to be awesome.
And then on Friday, FOU versus StarTail is going to be the last set of this.
Very important
for these two
teams.
Actually, if you think about it, that will really determine how the playoffs are going to be because StarTail could tie for first, or if they lose, they'll still be in the playoffs, but FOU will then clinch third place
and
knock IM
down. Right.
So very important matches next week to finish up the divisional play.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to those.
Those are going
to
be awesome.
They're very important matches. That's how the end of divisional play usually ends up. There's always like these little stories that are finally coming to an end. Well, TSL versus MVP, those two teams are just rocking everyone right now. And see them battled out should be awesome.
It's going to be great.
So don't forget Project A.
Yeah, Project
Watch
A
that.
Tonight. It's going to be coming up right after this. And it's been fun so far, so make sure.
It's been fun.
I mean, if you haven't watched Project A so far, you can go back and watch the VODs. It's kind of hard to find right now. You have to go to one of the leagues in the GOMTV.net section. Go to like the leagues and then go to GOMCAM, and that's where they're listed right now. So that's how you can find the past couple episodes of Project A. But that's going to be it for us today. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I am Moltrap. With me here is Wolf. We've had a pleasure casting for you today. Make sure you tune in next week for the Code A Finals on Monday. We'll see you there.